woman to be married to this man?
I do.
As God created the world, went down his list, everything he created, he named good. Created the heaven and the earth, he named it good. Created all the animals, the fish, the sea, the birds of the air, he named them good. But the first thing that God named not good was loneliness. The Lord God said, "It is not good that the man should be alone. I'll make a helper fit for him." And the man gave names to all the livestock, and to the birds of the heavens, and to every beast of the field. But there was not a helper that was found for Adam. So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man. And while he slept, he took one of his ribs. And in his place he closed up with flesh. And the rib that the Lord God had taken from the man he made into a woman and brought her to the man. And the man said, "This at last is the bone of my bones and the flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of man. Therefore, a man shall leave his father and his mother and hold fast to his wife, and they shall become one flesh." When the Lord made Eve out of Adam's rib, she was not taken from his head that she would rule over him, but she was also not taken from his foot that she might be trampled on by him. Instead, she was taken from his side that she might be equal to him, from under his arm that she might be protected by him, and from near his heart that she might be loved and cherished by him. Only God can take two people he's intended for each other and guide them through the years till they discover one another. Only God can take two people with their preferences and their goals, then blend their gifts and talents and unite their hearts. Only God can take two people with the joys they're dreaming of and make them one in marriage through his miracle of love. But what is love? It's just a four-letter word. We don't really know what that means. But wait. We have help. In the New Testament, Paul writes to the Corinthians, "If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I am a noisy gong and a clanging cymbal. If I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all the faith in the world to move mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give away all that I have, and if I deliver up my body to be sacrificed, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love does not envy, does not boast. It is not arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Love never ends." If y'all bow your heads and pray with me. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the words of your biblical authors who teach us about love and marriage. We thank you even more for your word made flesh, Jesus Christ, as he is our earthly example of your never-ending divine love. We ask that you be with us in the coming moments as Ashton and Nathaniel commit to loving each other as best they can, using the sacrificial example that Christ showed us on the cross. Lord, we love you. And we thank you for these two incredible people, and we thank you for the opportunity to support and celebrate them today. We pray all this in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Y'all can all sit, sorry. All right, this is the fun stuff. Nathaniel, repeat after me. Don't wait until I tell you. Nathaniel, here in the presence of God and your friends and family, do you declare your commitment to Ashton and choose her as the one with whom you wish to spend the rest of your life? Do you accept the gift of herself that she gives to you, and do you give yourself freely to her? Whoa. Do you pledge to endure all the difficulties that may come your way, even as you look forward to sharing the joys we experience together?
I do.
All right. Whoa. Ashton, here in the presence of God and your friends and family, do you declare your commitment to Nathaniel and choose him? Well, you probably teach him too. And choose him as the one with whom you were suspended the rest of your life? Do you accept the gift of himself that he gives to you, and do you give yourself to him freely? Do you pledge to endure all the difficulties that may come your way, even as you look forward to sharing the joys we experience together?
I do.
All right. Nathaniel, repeat after me. I, Nathaniel, take you, Ashton, to be my wedded wife.
I, Nathaniel, take you, Ashton, to be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better and for worse.
For better and for worse.
For richer and for poorer.
For richer and for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and understand.
To love and understand.
Let that be his part.
Let that be his part.
All right. Ashton. I, Ashton, take you, Nathaniel, to be my wedded husband.
I, Ashton, take you, Nathaniel, to be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and understand.
To love and understand.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
Rings. The wedding ring is a symbol of marriage in several different ways. It's a circle. So it has no beginning, it has no end. It's like God's love for us has no beginning and has no end. This love is the example that marriage is based on. Also, they're made of precious metals. Who knew? The precious metals of which these rings are made represent the purity and the value of that love. And these rings serve as a ceaseless reminder of the value that you two just made. Nathaniel, place the ring on your finger and repeat after me. With this ring, I pledge my life and love to you.
With this ring, I pledge my life and love to you.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
All right, Ashton. Place this ring on this ring. Yeah. Nathaniel. Oh, no.
Nope.
With this ring, I pledge my life and love to you. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
All right. For as much as Ashton and Nathaniel have consented together in marriage, and have witnessed the same before God and all of you, and have pledged their faith in and asserted their love for each other by the joining of hand and their giving and receiving of rings, and by the authority of God, in the laws of this state, I declare you husband and wife. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen.
Amen.
But then you can just ride. Great honor that I present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Nathaniel Smith.